Begin by finding a position for your body that feels comfortable for you. Maybe it's sitting in a chair or on a cushion. Maybe it's lying down. Whatever helps you to get comfortable, do that now. Notice what that comfort feels like in your body. And allow yourself to enjoy those sensations, to experience them as pleasant, even if they're small. And notice if there's any tension in your body at this time. Anywhere that your muscles are holding tightness. Scanning your body to look for tension. And gently inviting it to relax anywhere that you find it. Relaxing your body. As you relax your muscles, again, notice what those sensations are like and allow yourself to enjoy any pleasure associated with relaxation. And if you'd like, if it feels good for you, you can invite a gentle, easy smile to your face. Just a small smile. Doesn't have to be a huge grin. Letting this motion of your physical body incline you towards happiness. Enjoying this configuration of your body, being comfortable and relaxed with a gentle, easy smile on your face. continuing to maintain these qualities in your body, returning to them whenever necessary, begin to involve your mind. See if there are any short phrases you can tell yourself that would be loving to yourself. Things like, I love you. I'm so proud of you. I see how hard you're trying. I want you to be so happy. Perhaps something that is resonant for you. It's related to you and your current life situation. You can tell yourself the same phrase over and over again, or use many different phrases. In any case, use words in your mind to love yourself. Be sure that you can hear these phrases in your mind. Tell yourself anything that would be loving for you to hear. I know you're doing your best. It's okay to try. You're doing great. Anything that resonates for you is fair game. And again, to whatever extent you notice that there's pleasure or love, or any kind of enjoyment of this experience of loving yourself in this way, that positive feelings arise for you, notice those and really savor them. Soak those experiences up. You deserve to enjoy loving yourself. having prepared in this way, our bodies and our minds are tuned for love, are oriented towards love. Bring to mind your easy to love person or animal, whoever that is for you, and cultivate love for them in a way that you're familiar with, that you enjoy. Perhaps using mental talk as we did just now, or resonant visual images, a memory or an imagination. Perhaps by directly accessing feelings of love in your heart. Cultivate love for them now. Continue to cultivate love for your easy to love person or animal for another moment. Whatever extent you've cultivated love, continue to maintain that quality in your experience, staying connected to that feeling, that sensibility, that goodwill, friendliness. But begin to turn it in a different direction. Bring to mind someone that you care about. And come into contact with their desires, with their dreams, with their hopes for the future, their yearnings, their purpose, their vow. That's what this person longs for in their life, what they're directed towards, what they're aiming at, what they're here to do. You might see images in your mind or flash words into your experience that remind you of their qualities and their dreams, what you see in them, what you see them moving towards. Any way of getting in touch with this is perfectly fine. Simply connect to this person and their aspiration. See if you can imagine them succeeding at their dreams, fulfilling their purpose, achieving their vow. Imagine that in your mind's eye, what the world would look like, how it might be benefited, how it might make this person feel. To be so fully themselves, to have achieved their end, to have arrived in their fullness. Imagine what that would look like. See if you can feel what that world would be like, where this person was so fulfilled, being so fully themselves, that their very existence serves the world. Ask your body what that would feel like. And feel what it knows. Body knows many things the mind may never understand. And the heart has tremendous love that the world wishes to receive. As you connect to this sense of this person and their vow and the impact that they'll have in the world, see if you can feel love for them. See if you can celebrate their success. Will it into existence with your body. See if mudita is available for you. This celebration for them. Joy just because. You find this love, this celebration, this mudita in your heart. Stabilize it. Ground yourself in it. Become it. And if for some reason it's not available to you at this time to feel, reestablish it in your mind using images or words, connecting to this person and their vow, their aspiration. See if you can spark this desire for them to succeed, to flourish. Very good. Now, see if there's some way that this mudita might like to manifest in the world. If there's some act of love, some manifestation of kindness that yearns to come into being as a result of this practice period. Consider if there's anything like that that's wanting to happen. And if so, lightly set the intention to do it in the near future. And as you're ready, at your own pace, you can come out of the meditation.